See, nice and shiny.
It was Dollar Shave Club. That was the shave butter that I bought it wasn't yesterday. It was, when was it? I don't know. I bought like a few days ago from Walmart. It works pretty good. It's not as good as the ProGlide clear gel that Gillette used to have. But it works good. It's still good. So anyway, I'm going to read more of Deuteronomy. The fifth book of Moses, the Pentateuch, the fifth book of the Old Testament. It's actually like a repeat of the first three books before it, like of Exodus, Leviticus, and Numbers. It's like Moses does a rehash of everything that happened with the Jews and him. So it's in more detail. But first, the Gospel. So Jesus was the Son of God. He came as a man. He was fully God and fully man, and he kept the law of God perfectly. He was the only man who ever did not sin. He was subject to the same weaknesses as we were. He was tempted like we were, but he never gave in. He never sinned. He fulfilled hundreds of prophecies about himself in the Old Testament, and there's still more, many more, hundreds more, that he will fulfill in his second coming. So in his first coming, he filled 300 and something prophecies, and he came through virgin birth. The Holy Spirit made Mary to become pregnant with him, so he was the Son of God in that God was his Father. God caused him to be the only begotten of the Father, the only man who was begotten of God, directly from God, through a virgin birth. So he had the flesh of man, so that he could keep the law for us, then take our punishment upon himself, be whipped and beaten, abandoned. His body bore our sicknesses and our pains, and he bore our iniquities, our sin. And then he was abandoned by all, and he was crucified. He was nailed to the cross by his hands and feet. He died on that cross. He was pierced in the side, and outflowed water and blood. And so the water was the rock. When Moses was in the wilderness with the Israelites, after they were delivered out of Egypt, God told Moses first to strike a rock. God said he would go stand on the rock of Horeb, and he would bring him water. And so he told Moses first to strike the rock in Exodus 17. So he said to strike it one time. And then in Numbers, he said, speak to the rock. So Moses, when he obeyed God, he did it only partially. He struck the rock two times. He did not speak to the rock the second time. But Jesus, when that rock was struck, water came out, and it gave the Israelites water in the desert, who were complaining against God. But because of God's great mercy, and Moses being an intercessor, brought forth water for them through the rock. And then so Jesus was the rock. He was crucified on the cross, and his side was pierced, and water flowed out. God gave us living water. From him, out of his belly, flows living water. That's the Holy Spirit. And when Jesus died on the cross, he was buried in the grave. Then he was resurrected 3 days later, and he was seen by all his followers. And then he walked the earth for 40 more days preaching the gospel, and he appeared to over 500 people at one time. And then he ascended back to the right hand of the Father. The disciples watched him go up into the clouds. And then he said to the disciples before he went up to wait in Jerusalem for the promise of the Father. In the Old Testament, God promised that he would pour out his Spirit upon all flesh, that he would give them a new heart, that he would write his laws on their heart rather than on tablets of stone, like he did in Exodus and in Numbers and Deuteronomy. And then he the disciples waited in Jerusalem, and then the Holy Spirit was sent. Jesus baptized them in the Holy Spirit. Jesus sent the Spirit. The Father sent the Spirit. Jesus was at the right hand of the Father in heaven. This Holy Spirit proceeds forth from God. It is the Spirit of Christ, and it is the Spirit of our Father in heaven. And it's the Holy Spirit, it's the Spirit of God. They're all God. There's one God. The Lord our God is one, but He is three persons. He is the Father, who was always in heaven, who is Spirit, and we can't see Him. Jesus was the Word that was made flesh. We see Him. Even Moses saw Jesus. He saw Him in the burning bush. Jesus appeared to Abraham. So Jesus appeared. God appeared to many men in the Old Testament, and that was Jesus. He was referred to as the angel of God. And like Joshua, we're going to read in the next book, Joshua saw God, Jesus, and Jesus told him to take off his sandals because where he stood is holy ground. When Moses saw the burning bush, God told him to take off his sandals, where he stood is holy ground. So Jesus baptized in the Holy Spirit. He sent the Spirit, and then they went and did the same things that he did. They preached the gospel with power. The Holy Spirit was sent to give us power to be witnesses to him to all the ends of the earth. And ever since then, God's kingdom has been growing. Many people have been repenting and believing in him and becoming born by God from above. Jesus said that unless a man be born again, he cannot enter the kingdom of heaven or kingdom of God. And we enter in through faith. If we put our trust and our faith in Jesus, that he died on the cross for our sins, he paid for our sin debt, because we all sin, we're all guilty before God, and that we believe that God raised him from the dead, that he raised from the dead, and we confess him Lord, we believe in our heart that he raised from the dead and confess him Lord with our mouth, we will be saved. And then we will receive the Holy Spirit. We become one with God through faith in Jesus. Jesus is the door. He is the way. He is the way we enter into God. Jesus said that no man comes to the Father but through me. I am the way, the truth, and the life. No man comes to the Father but through me. And he said, I and the Father are one. And that he would send the Spirit, and that he would not leave us orphans. He would come to us. So he is the Father, he is the Spirit, he is the Son, he is God, the Father is God, Jesus is God, the Holy Spirit is God, but Jesus is not the Father is not Jesus, the Holy Spirit is not the Father, Holy Spirit is not Jesus, and Jesus is not the Holy Spirit, the Father is not the Holy Spirit, but they're God, it's one God. It's a mystery because God is God. He created us, fallible beings, and we can't tell him who he is. He tells us who he is. The only truth that we have that reveals who he is his Spirit. He tells us and reveals it to our heart, but through his word. His word testifies of who he is, and he says that he is three persons, but he's one God. So we must believe it. If you believe it and receive him, you will be saved. You will be restored to God through faith in Jesus. You'll have a relationship with him, and you will walk as he walked. You will become righteous as he was righteous. You will turn away from your sin, and he will make you like Jesus. And eventually you will sin less and less and less and become more and more like him. You will look more and more like him. He will transform you into the image of his Son by the word, the renewing of your mind by the word, and you will prove his good and perfect will by knowing what his word says, believing what his word says, and obeying him. Jesus says, if you love me, you will keep my commands. And those who love me, I will reveal myself to him, and I will come to him, and my Father will come to him, and I will send the Spirit who will be with you forever. Hallelujah. That is God. That is the gospel. Believe it and be saved. And if you need healing in your body, Jesus bore our sickness and our pains on his body at the whipping post. When the Romans scourged him, they tore off the flesh off his back. That was part of the atonement in Isaiah 53. He bore our griefs and carried our sorrows, some translations say. But if you look at the Hebrew words, it actually is sicknesses and pains. And Matthew, in his gospel in chapter 8, verse 17, he confirms that that's what it is. He says that he took up our weaknesses and bore our sicknesses. And that's the truth. So we receive that by faith, and we can give it by faith. Jesus said that those who believe in me would do the same works that I do and even greater. And that if we, whatever we say, believing, we will have. So we speak to the mountain, command it to be cast into the sea, do not doubt, believe in our heart, and it will happen. We put our trust in him that what we say, he will do. Because he is God, he has paid for all of our sickness and disease already. It's done 2,000 years ago, and you receive it by my faith in his name. His name means salvation, and you be free right now in the name of Jesus Christ. I speak life to your body. I command you, be healed now, be free now in the name of Jesus. Amen. All right. So I went all the longer than I was gonna try and make it really short. But anyway, this will go on to Deuteronomy chapter 5, and I'll stop wherever I feel like it. Okay, so Deuteronomy chapter 5. And Moses called all Israel and said to them, "Hear, O Israel, the statutes and judgments which I speak in your hearing today, that you may learn them and be careful to observe them. The Lord our God made a covenant with us in Horeb." That was the rock of Horeb. "The Lord did not make this covenant with our fathers, but with us, those who are here today, all of us who are alive. The Lord talked with you face to face on the mountain from the midst of the fire. I stood between the Lord and you at that time to declare to you the word of the Lord, for you were afraid because of the fire, and you did not go up to the up the mountain. He said, 'I am the Lord your God who brought you out of the land of Egypt, out of the house of bondage. You shall have no other gods before me. You shall not make for yourself a carved image, any likeness of anything that is in heaven above, or that is in the earth beneath, or that is in the water under the earth. You shall not bow down to them nor serve them, for I, the Lord, your God, am a jealous God, visiting the iniquity of your fathers upon the children to the third and fourth generation of those who hate me, but showing mercy to thousands to those who love me and keep my commandments. You shall not take the name of the Lord your God in vain, for the Lord will not hold him guiltless who takes his name in vain. Observe the Sabbath to keep it holy, and the Lord your God, as the Lord your God commanded you. 6 days you shall labor and do all your work, but the seventh day is the Sabbath of the Lord your God. In it you shall do no work, you, nor your son, nor your daughter, nor your male servant, nor your female servant, nor your ox, nor your donkey, nor any of your cattle, nor your stranger who is with you within your gates, that you, your male servant and your female servant may rest as well as you. And remember that you were a slave in the land of Egypt, and the Lord your God brought you out from there by a mighty hand and by an outstretched arm. Therefore, the Lord your God commanded you to keep the Sabbath day. Honor your father and your mother, as the Lord your God has commanded you, that your days may be long, that it may be well with you in the land which the Lord your God is giving you. You shall not murder, you shall not commit adultery, you shall not steal, you shall not bear false witness against your neighbor, you shall not covet your neighbor's wife, and you shall not desire your neighbor's house, his field, his male servant, his female servant, his ox, his donkey, or anything that is your neighbor's. These words the Lord spoke to all your assembly in the mountain from the midst of the fire, the cloud, and the thick darkness with a loud voice, and he said no more. And he wrote them on 2 tablets of stone and gave them to me. So it was, when you heard the voice from the midst of the darkness, while the mountain was burning with fire, that you came near to me, all the heads of your tribes and your elders. And you said, 'Surely the Lord our God has shown us his glory and his greatness, and we have heard his voice from the midst of the fire. We have seen this day that God speaks with man, yet he still lives. Now therefore, why should we die? For this great fire will consume us. If we hear the voice of the Lord our God any more, then we shall die. For who is there of all flesh who has heard the voice of the living God speaking from the midst of the fire, as we have, and lived? You go near and hear all that the Lord our God may say, and tell us all that the Lord our God says to you, and we will hear and do it. Then the Lord heard the voice of your words when you spoke to me, and the Lord said to me, I have heard the voice of the words of this people, which they have spoken to you. They are right in all that they have spoken. Oh, that they had such a heart in them that they would fear me and always keep all my commandments, that it might be well with them and with their children forever. Go and say to them, return to your tents. But as for you, stand here by me, and I will speak to you all the commandments, the statutes, and the judgments which you shall teach them, that they may observe them in the land which I am giving them to possess. Therefore, you shall be careful to do all that the Lord your God has commanded you. You shall not turn aside to the right hand or to the left. You shall walk in all the ways which the Lord your God has commanded you, that you may live, and that you may be well with, or that it may be well with you, and that you may prolong your days in the land which you shall possess. Deuteronomy chapter 6. Now this is the commandment, and these are the statutes and judgments which the Lord your God has commanded to teach you, that you may observe them in the land which you are crossing over to possess, that you may fear the Lord your God, to keep all his statutes and his commandments, which I command you, you and your sons and your grandson, all the day, you and your son and your grandson, all the days of your life, and that your days may be prolonged. Therefore, hear, O Israel, and be careful to observe it, that it may be well with you, and that you may multiply greatly as the Lord God of your fathers has promised you, a land flowing with milk and honey. Hear, O Israel, the Lord our God, the Lord is one. That's Deuteronomy 6:4. Hear, O Israel, the Lord our God, the Lord is one. But he is Father, Son, Holy Spirit. You shall love the Lord your God with all your heart, with all your soul, and with all your strength. And these words which I command you today shall be in your heart. You shall teach them diligently to your children, and shall talk of them when you sit in your house, when you walk by the way, when you lie down, and when you rise up. You shall bind them as a sign on your hand, and they shall be as frontlets between your eyes. You shall write them on the doorposts of your house and on your gates. So it shall be when the Lord your God brings you into the land of which he swore to your fathers, to Abraham, Isaac, and Jacob, to give you large and beautiful cities which you did not build, houses full of all good things that you did not fill, hewn out wells which you did not dig, vineyards and olive trees which you did not plant, when you have eaten and are full, then beware lest you forget the Lord who brought you out of the land of Egypt from the house of bondage. You shall fear the Lord your God and serve him, and shall take oaths in his name. You shall not go after other gods, the gods of the people who are all around you. For the Lord your God is a jealous God among you, lest the anger of the Lord your God be aroused against you and destroy you from the face of the earth. You shall not tempt the Lord your God as you tempted him in Massah. You shall diligently keep the commandments of the Lord your God, his testimonies and his statutes, which he has commanded you. And you shall do what is right and good in the sight of the Lord, that it may be well with you, and that you may go in and possess the land, the good land of which the Lord swore to your fathers, to cast out all your enemies from before you, as the Lord has spoken. When your son asks you in time to come, saying, what is the meaning of the testimonies, the statutes, and the judgments which the Lord our God has commanded you? Then you shall say to your son, we were slaves of Pharaoh in Egypt, and the Lord brought us out of Egypt with a mighty hand, and the Lord showed signs and wonders before our eyes, great and severe, against Egypt, Pharaoh, and all his household, when he brought us out from there, that he might bring us in and give us the land of which he swore to our fathers. And the Lord commanded us to observe all these statutes, to fear the Lord our God for our good always, that he might preserve us alive as it is this day. Then it will be righteous for you if we are careful to observe all these commandments before the Lord our God, as he has commanded us. Deuteronomy chapter 7. When the Lord your God brings you into the land which you go to possess and has cast out many nations before you, the Hittites and the Girgashites and the Amorites and the Canaanites and the Perizzites and the Hivites and the Jebusites, seven nations greater and mightier than you, and when the Lord your God delivers them over to you. You shall conquer them and utterly destroy them. You shall make no covenant with them, nor show mercy to them. Nor shall you make marriages with them. You shall not give your daughters to them, to their son, nor take their daughters for your son, or their daughter for your son. For they will turn your sons away from following me to serve other gods. So the anger of the Lord will be aroused against you and destroy you suddenly. But this you shall deal with them. You shall destroy their altars and break down their sacred pillars and cut down their wooden images and burn their carved images with fire. For you are a holy people to the Lord your God. The Lord your God has chosen you to be a people for himself, a special treasure above all the peoples on the face of the earth. For the Lord did not set his love on you nor choose you because you were more in number than any other people. For you are the least of all peoples. And even this day, there are only 18 million, all the Jews and all the earth. There's only like 7 million, I think, in Israel, or 8 million. But because the Lord loves you, and because he would keep the oath which he swore to your fathers, the Lord has brought you out with a mighty hand and redeemed you from the house of bondage, from the hand of Pharaoh, king of Egypt. Therefore, know that the Lord your God, he is God, the faithful God who keeps covenant and mercy for 1,000 generations with those who love him and keep his commandments. And he repays those who hate him to their face to destroy them. He will not be slack with him who hates him. He will repay him to his face. Therefore, you shall keep the commandment, the statutes, and the judgments which I command you today to observe them. Then it shall come to pass, because you listen to these judgments and keep and do them, that the Lord your God will keep you with you the covenant and the mercy which he swore to your fathers. And he will love you and bless you and multiply you. He will also bless the fruit of your womb and the fruit of your land, your grain and your new wine and your oil, the increase of your cattle and the offspring of your flock in the land in which he swore to your fathers to give you. You shall be blessed above all peoples. There shall not be a male or female barren among you or among your livestock. And the Lord will take away from you all sickness, and he will afflict you with none of the terrible diseases of Egypt, which you have known, but will lay them on all those who hate you. Also, you shall destroy all the peoples whom the Lord your God delivers over to you. Your eye shall not have no pity on them, nor shall you serve their gods, for that will be a snare to you. If you should say in your heart, "These nations are greater than I, how can I dispossess them?" you shall not be afraid of them, but you shall remember well what the Lord your God did to Pharaoh and to all Egypt. The great trials which your eyes saw, the signs and the wonders, the mighty hand and the outstretched arm by which the Lord your God brought you out, so shall the Lord your God do to all the peoples of whom you are afraid. Moreover, the Lord your God will send the hornet among them until those who are left, who hide themselves from you, are destroyed. You shall not be terrified of them, for the Lord your God, the great and awesome God, is among you. And the Lord your God will drive out those nations before you little by little. You will be unable to destroy them at once, lest the beasts of the field become too numerous for you. But the Lord your God will deliver them over to you and will inflict defeat upon them until they are destroyed. And he will deliver their kings into your hand, and you will deliver, or you will destroy their name from under heaven. No one shall be able to stand against you until you have destroyed them. You shall burn the carved images of their gods with fire. You shall not covet the silver or gold that is on them, nor take it for yourself, lest you be snared by it. For it is an abomination to the Lord your God. Nor shall you bring an abomination into your house, lest you be doomed to destruction like it. You shall utterly detest it and utterly abhor it, for it is an accursed thing. Deuteronomy chapter 8. Every commandment which I command you today, you must be careful to observe, that you may live and multiply and go in and possess the land of which the Lord swore to your fathers. And you shall remember that the Lord your God led you all the way these 40 years in the wilderness to humble you and test you, to know what was in your heart, whether you would keep his commandments or not. So he humbled you, allowed you to hunger and fed you with manna, which you did not know, nor did your fathers know, that he might make you know that man shall not live by bread alone, but man lives by every word that proceeds from the mouth of the Lord. Your garments did not wear out on you, nor did your feet swell for 40 years. You should know in your heart that as a man chastens his son, so the Lord your God chastens you. Therefore, you shall keep the commandments of the Lord your God to walk in his ways and to fear him. For the Lord your God is bringing you into a good land, a land of brooks of water, of fountains and springs that flow out of valleys and hills, a land of wheat and barley, of vines and fig trees and pomegranates, a land of olive oil and honey, a land in which you will eat bread without scarcity, in which you will lack nothing, a land whose stones are iron and out of whose hills you can dig copper. When you have eaten and are full, then you shall bless the Lord your God for the good land which he has given you. Beware that you do not forget the Lord your God by not keeping his commandments, his judgments, and his statutes, which I command you today, lest when you have eaten and are full, and have built beautiful houses and dwell in them, and when your herds and your flocks multiply, and your silver and your gold are multiplied, and all that you have is multiplied, when your heart is lifted up, and you forget the Lord your God who brought you out of the land of Egypt from the house of bondage, who led you through that great and terrible wilderness in which were fiery serpents and scorpions and thirsty land where there was no water, who brought water for you out of the flinty rock, Jesus, who fed you in the wilderness with manna, which your fathers did not know, that he might humble you and that he might test you to do you good in the end. Then you say in your heart, my power and my might of my hand have gained me this wealth. And you shall remember the Lord your God, for it is he who gives you power to get wealth, that he may establish his covenant which he swore to your fathers, as it is this day. Deuteronomy 8:18. Every time you see 8:18, think of that. It is the Lord your God who gives you power to make wealth, that he may establish his covenant which he swore to your fathers, as it is this day. Then it shall be, if you by any means forget the Lord your God and follow other gods and serve them and worship them, I testify against you this day that you shall surely perish. As the nations which the Lord destroyed before you, so you shall perish, because you did not be obedient to the voice of the Lord your God. Deuteronomy chapter 9. Hear, O Israel, you are to cross over the Jordan today and go in to dispossess nations greater and mightier than yourself, cities great and fortified up to heaven, a people great and tall, the descendants of the Anakim, whom you know and of whom you heard it said, who can stand before the descendants of Anak? Therefore, understand today that the Lord your God is he who goes over before you as a consuming fire. He will destroy them and bring them down before you. So you shall drive them out and destroy them quickly, as the Lord has said to you. Do not think in your heart after the Lord your God has cast them out before you, saying, because of my righteousness the Lord has brought me in to possess this land, but it is because of the wickedness of these nations that the Lord is driving them out from before you. It is not because of your righteousness or the right uprightness of your heart that you go in to possess their land, but because of the wickedness of these nations that the Lord your God drives them out from before you, and that he may fulfill the word which the Lord swore to your fathers, to Abraham, Isaac, and Jacob. Therefore, understand that the Lord your God is not giving you this good land to possess because of your righteousness, for you are a stiff-necked people. Remember, do not forget how you provoked the Lord your God with wrath in the wilderness. From the day that you departed from the land of Egypt until you came to this place, you have been rebellious against the Lord. Also in Horeb, you provoked the Lord to wrath, so that the Lord was angry enough with you to have destroyed you. When I went up into the mountain to receive the tablets of stone, the tablets of the covenant which the Lord made with you, then I stayed on the mountain 40 days and 40 nights. I neither ate bread nor drank water. Then the Lord delivered to me 2 tablets of stone written with the finger of God. And on them were all the words which the Lord had spoken to you on the mountain from the midst of the fire in the day of the assembly. And it came to pass at the end of 40 days and 40 nights that the Lord gave me the 2 tablets of stone, the tablets of the covenant. Then the Lord said to me, "Arise, go down quickly from here, for your people whom you brought out of Egypt have acted corruptly. They have quickly turned aside from the way which I commanded them. They have made themselves a molded image. Furthermore, the Lord spoke to me, saying, 'I have seen this people, and indeed they are a stiff-necked people. Let me alone, that I may destroy them and blot out their names from under heaven, and I will make you a nation mightier and greater than they.' So I turned and came down from the mountain, and the mountain burned with fire, and the 2 tablets of the covenant were in my 2 hands. Then I looked, and behold, you had sinned against the Lord your God, had made for yourselves a molded calf. You had turned aside quickly from the way which the Lord had commanded you. Then I took the 2 tablets and threw them out of my 2 hands and broke them before your eyes. And I fell down before the Lord, as at the first 40 days and 40 nights. I neither ate bread nor drank water because of all your sin which you committed in doing wickedly in the sight of the Lord to provoke him to anger. For I was afraid of the anger and hot displeasure with which the Lord was angry with you to destroy you. But the Lord listened to me at that time also. And the Lord was very angry with Aaron and would have destroyed him. So I prayed for Aaron also at that same time. Then I took your sin, the calf which you had made, and burned it with fire and crushed it and ground it very small until it was as fine as dust. And I threw its dust into the brook that descended from the mountain. Also at Taberah and Massa and Kibaroth Hattaavah, you provoked the Lord to wrath. Likewise, when the Lord sent you from Kadesh Barnea, saying, 'Go up and possess the land which I have given you,' then you rebelled against the commandment of the Lord your God, and you did not believe him nor obey his voice. You have been rebellious against the Lord from the day that I knew you. Thus I prostrated myself before the Lord 40 days and 40 nights. I kept prostrating myself because the Lord had said he would destroy you. Therefore, I prayed to the Lord and said, 'O Lord God, do not destroy your people and your inheritance, whom you have redeemed through your greatness, whom you have brought out of Egypt with a mighty hand. Remember your servants, Abraham, Isaac, and Jacob. Do not look on the stubbornness of this people or on their wickedness or their sin, lest the land from which you brought us should say, because the Lord was not able to bring them to the land which he promised them, and because he hated them, he has brought them out to kill them in the wilderness. Yet they are your people and your inheritance, whom you brought out by your mighty power and by your outstretched arm.'" Deuteronomy chapter 10. "At that time the Lord said to me, 'Hew for yourself 2 tablets of stone like the first, and come up to me on the mountain and make yourself an ark of wood. And I will write on the tablets the words that were on the first tablets, which you broke, and you shall put them in the ark.' So I made an ark of acacia wood, hewed 2 tablets of stone like the first, and went up the mountain, having the 2 tablets in my hand. And he wrote on the tablets, according to the first writing, the 10 commandments, which the Lord had spoken to you in the mountain from the midst of the fire in the day of the assembly, and the Lord gave them to me. Then I turned and came down from the mountain and put the tablets in the ark which I had made. And there they are, just as the Lord commanded me. Now the children of Israel journeyed from the wells of Bene Jaakan to Masorah, where Aaron died and where he was buried, and Eleazar his son ministered as priest in his stead. From there they journeyed to Gudgoda, and from Gudgoda to Jotbathan, a land of rivers of water. At that time the Lord separated the tribe of Levi to bear the Ark of the Covenant of the Lord, to stand before the Lord, to minister to him, and to bless in his name. To this day Therefore, Levi has no portion nor inheritance with his brethren. The Lord is his inheritance, just as the Lord your God promised him. As at the first time I stayed in the mountain 40 days and 40 nights, the Lord also heard me at that time, and the Lord chose not to destroy you. Then the Lord said to me, arise, begin your journey before the people, that they may go in and possess the land which I swore to their fathers to give them. And now, Israel, what does the Lord your God require of you but to fear the Lord your God, to walk in all his ways and to love him, to serve the Lord your God with all your heart and with all your soul, and to keep the commandments of the Lord and his statutes which I command you today for your good? Indeed, heaven and the highest heavens belong to the Lord your God, also the earth with all that is in it. The Lord delighted only in your fathers to love them, and he chose their descendants after them, you above all peoples, as it is this day. Therefore, circumcise the foreskin of your heart and be stiff-necked no longer. For the Lord your God is God of gods and Lord of lords, the great God, mighty and awesome, who shows no partiality nor takes a bribe. He administers justice for the fatherless and the widow. He loves the stranger, gives him food and clothing. Therefore, love the stranger, for you were strangers in the land of Egypt. You shall fear the Lord your God, you shall serve him, and to him you shall hold fast and take oaths in his name. He is your praise, and he is your God, who has done for you these great and awesome things which your eyes have seen. Your fathers went down to Egypt with 70 persons, and now the Lord your God has made you as the stars of heaven in multitude. I'm going to stop there. I like to keep it under 40 minutes. If I go on to 11, I think it'll go past 40 minutes. So, that is up to Deuteronomy chapter 10, and I will begin on 11 next time. So thank you for listening, and God bless you all. If you would like me to pray for you, reach out to me at lovesflame.com at the Contact Us tab, and I would be more than happy to pray for you and believe for you for whatever your need is, whether it be healing, deliverance, provision, whatever it is. I'm there for you. I make myself available to you in that way. And whatever way I can. Till next time, grace, peace, and love in Jesus Christ. Bye.